there are these few people who, against all odds, their core little inner flame just keeps burning. She has followed that flame all the way through, so of course she's kind of the same wild soul she was at the beginning. She's an extremist in that she sticks to what she believes and always has, but she does it for love and for hope. And that's why she galvanizes people to her. It's subversive to be loving, to not be cynical, to just be your genuine self.
Tiger Lily is the most significant album I've ever made. It defined me as a songwriter, and it established this intimate connection between myself and the audience that's been supporting and sustaining me ever since.
I grew up with Natalie, sort of always playing in the background because my mother was a fan. But then when Tiger Lily came out, as I was a 13-year-old girl, it was the first CD that was actually mine, the one that I bought myself.
Every song on that album is like something that you have felt before, and it could be the most ecstatic feeling in the world. It can also be like the most heavy.
Yeah, I'm not your typical Natalie Merchant fan, but I love what she does. I love her writing. I love what she stands for, and I love that she perseveres through all this stuff and doesn't care. She does what she wants to do, and she has a very big group of people that care about what she does.
Why would I make the same record again 20 years later? Why re-record Tiger Lily? I think we all have some experience in our lives that we wish we could relive. We think if we could retrace our steps and replay the events, that the outcome would be different. But how, and in which ways?